happen is this. In the reality of playing a match, you only hit at most 8 to 10 balls at any given time. So we're gonna go through a rotation. We're gonna be hitting about 8 to 10 balls. We're gonna stop for about 30 seconds and then pick up again, non-stop, and then stop again. The idea being that we start to really replicate what happened in the first game. So your intensity has to stay on for a short burst, and then we stop, rest. Short burst again, then we rest. Don't stop, don't stop, don't stop, don't stop. Let's go. Good, 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 good. Let's go. Get right to it. Let's go. Produce your strokes. Go. Less about mechanics and more about your movement, which is interesting because it becomes how you get to the ball because you know how to strike the ball. Now the question is, can we get your body to run down that ball that's no longer traveling 20 miles an hour but traveling 40, 50, 60 miles an hour? If you're not playing well, the first thing that goes is your footwork. I watch it week in and week out. It's the first thing that goes. So if you think you've set a baseline of just a minimal amount of footwork, you're going to see a great surge in your tennis. So make sure you're aware that you play your matches. Stop standing still. Stop resting on your heels. Keep a bounce to your step. That's just a bare minimum, and you'll see a huge jump in your game.